CNN has just confirmed that the Transportation Secretary Elaine Chao is resigning from the president's cabinet. She resigned yesterday and is directly tying it, Brianna, to President Trump's response to that mob of his loyalists descending on Capitol Hill and breaching the halls of federal government. And this is significant because she is the first cabinet secretary so far to resign as a result of what the president did yesterday. We've heard a lot of other people are considering it. We've seen some pretty significant figures, including the deputy national security advisor, resign in wake of that. But now this is Elaine Chao, the transportation secretary, who has been here almost every day of Donald Trump's presidency, serving with him, working with him, and defending him, and now she is resigning as a direct result of what he did yesterday. And of course, she is someone who worked closely with the president. She was obviously in the cabinet, a top-ranking official in the administration, but also this is notable for another reason, because she is married to the Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, and you saw how McConnell turned on the president in a really remarkable way yesterday that we have not seen in the 4 years that Donald Trump has been in office. And so now we are learning that Elaine Chao is the first person from the cabinet to resign as a result of what the president did yesterday. But the question, of course, that is on everyone's mind, including inside the White House, is whether or not she is going to be the last. And we should remind viewers, this is likely the reason the president put out that statement overnight saying that there will be an orderly transition of power on January 20th, because there is a real concern inside the White House that you are going to see a series of high-profile mass resignations coming out of the president's top-ranking officials. Elaine Chao is one of the first.
Wow. I mean, we just have never seen anything like this. But I wonder, Caitlin, if you can also explain to us how this would maybe, you know, one of the things that has been discussed is the 25th Amendment, and that cabinet members are considering that as an option on the table for a way to remove President Trump from office. Obviously, if you have cabinet members who are resigning, that will change this a calculation, or perhaps that maybe was something that didn't really have feet, if you will.
Yeah, I think there has definitely been serious conversation about it. The question is, you know, whether or not it's serious enough for them to actually put into practice, because that's something that would involve the vice president and several other officials. I'm not sure if even acting cabinet officials can play a role in that. And of course, there are several acting officials in this administration, including at the Justice Department, at the Pentagon, at the Department of Homeland Security, really all over the cabinet. And so those are questions that are being raised, but this is definitely a conversation. You know, we talked about the 25th Amendment during the Russia investigation, and that was something that really didn't seem to have a tight grasp on reality at the time, that it was something that could actually happen. This does seem closer to it, but people do still think we're more likely to see mass resignations like what we're seeing with Elaine Chao right now than something of that nature. Though there are Republicans, people like Adam Kinzinger on Capitol Hill, who are calling to invoke the 25th Amendment, because I think the concern that people have, you know, you might hear, well, we've only got 2 weeks left. What's the point of doing that? I think what we saw yesterday and the way the president responded and was reluctant to send out the National Guard as his loyalists were descending on Capitol Hill, it's concerned people for what the next 13 days could look like, given that the president, you know, has really been in a desperate state of mind, more so than he has been given this election loss. And so I think that is the concern. That's what's driving these conversations, and that's what's playing a role in these resignations that we could be seeing.
All right, Caitlin, thank you for sharing the breaking news with us. I want to get back to our panelists here to talk about this. Carl Bernstein, to you. I mean, what is your reaction to this, learning of the first cabinet resignation, Transportation Secretary Elaine Chao, who is, of course, the Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell's wife as well?
Well, I think, first of all, there really is an example of rats leaving the sinking ship. And at the same time, the concern of McConnell, the concern of his wife about the instability and really madness of the President of the United States is real. What's really called for here is, yes, the 25th Amendment ought to be invoked. If it can't be, and I think there's a growing view that what has to be done is somehow Donald Trump, in the last 2 weeks of his presidency, must be put in some kind of constitutional straitjacket so that he cannot further endanger the national security of this country, that legal mechanisms, as well as pressure from McConnell, from perhaps the joint leadership of both parties in Congress, calling on the President of the United States for either his resignation, for him to be isolated, and with Mike Pence, the Vice President, participating in some kind of consensus that says we have safely isolated the President of the United States so that he can no longer undermine the stability and national security interests of the United States. Look, he has been acting like a madman, the word has been used to me, for weeks and weeks. This has been well known. There was a kind of inevitability, not necessarily the breaching the Capitol yesterday and getting inside the Capitol, but that he has been trying to provoke his followers, this cult, to cause some kind of provocation, indeed, that would let him stage a coup and stay in office. He must be restrained. And that there is recognition by McConnell, by the vice president, by members of the cabinet, he must be restrained in the interest of national security and the people of this country, especially at this moment.
And I am in a moment here, Laura, going to ask you about the 25th Amendment requirements and sort of how that might work. I just want to get Dana's reaction real quick, though, to this reporting on Elaine Chao resigning.
Listen, it's huge. Carl makes a very fair point that Chao, as other cabinet members who have been there since the start, and she's one of them, have had to, you know, suck it up or turn the other cheek. You know, people might be even more critical, saying that they were complicit. You know, when you're transportation secretary, perhaps it's you're a little bit further removed from the crazy and from the madman. But, you know, being a Trump cabinet official is something that will always be with her. She was the longest serving cabinet member for George W. Bush. She has been in this town for a very long time, a very loyal Republican, even separate and apart from the fact that she happens to be married to Mitch McConnell. She is an immigrant. She came here to the United States when she was very young, and she has that sensibility, and, you know, certainly would be